All right, very quick. I remember now. I remember now. The second thing, watch out, you know, before I get cast off into the Alzheimer query. The second thing was making money. We have to be making money always, don't we, for the arts? And so I came up with a kind of a neat idea that we can make a CD, an opera CD. But it would be only the ballet dancers. It would be the ballet dancers from the opera houses that now sing. And so maybe in their lifetime, since the dancing or during the dancing, they've acquired the skill to sing arias, their librettos there. And so we can have the men and the women, special ones, just a few. They don't have to sing the whole thing. They don't have to be Callas, the entire CD. But maybe one or two songs each, and so that would be kind of just like a wow, just a wow factor. And so we don't have to perform it; it would just simply be a recording event, a recorded event, and so it would be kind of something that is just unique, and not many people would just ever in their lifetimes dream of. So here we are; we're like the Tiger Woods, you know. That return from one, we do one thing and then we become another. I'm not sure. Tiger Woods did something first, but then it was golf, and then nobody remembers what the first thing was. But I think he did something first, and I believe there is another. There's a singer, a bachelor. I think it was Bachelor, who was the dancer and then the singer. But I could be wrong. It was one of them. So we have. This option, and that is like a weird drumming up of the money, and it doesn't have to be sold everywhere in every hair tea or every Leclerc, but in a way it's kind of fun because maybe we are like these strange secret stars, you know, the secret stars, but I don't want it publicized like the fanatic English way. Or the American way, where it's this idol situation. I can't stand it. I can't stand any of this Dancing with the Stars shows. I think that's just gross. So what we need to do is just be a secret little CD. So we'll have our recordings off, and make our secret CD, and we'll sell it first right there at the opera houses themselves. And then from there, possibly, even at the tourist bureaus. At the tourist bureau is an interesting place. And so they could buy it there while they're just saying, well, what else we do? We'll pop that into the car as we're driving down the road because we're the tourists. And so we'll sell it to strange places like that instead of trying to get into the big supermarkets. And so we give them opera. And so that'll be kind of funny. So any of you opera singers out there also who used to be the ballet dancers, you're very welcome to join in that one. So that will be a new trick that we do that hypes up money also. What we do with the money, I don't know, but it will be just something fun. Aside from, we could pay ourselves, but aside from that, it can still be fun for the listeners to hear the dancer sing the opera. So that would be a shock, because many of us still are, you know, thought of as dancers only, and then they find out that, oh my gosh, he's a baritone, like tremendous, and I really prefer him over Mr. Andreas Scholl. And they're just like, whoa, what is going on? And so what if somebody is hyped into major fame, you know? Who cares? That's not the point. I don't want this to be a major fame event unless that person really wants it. I was just thinking, you know, just a consolidated CD would be so cute. It would be so cute for us to have as, you know, a gift of who we are. Because in a way we can't stop, can we? When I think about it, I just can't stop being in the theater, event of it, what it offers, so I don't know, the lifelong habit, I suppose. There we go. That will be a cute little deal, and we could offer that at the tourist bureaus around the European Union. And all right.